Hello, this presentation is titled How to Simplify Machine Learning Workflow Specifications. This is a useR 2020 conference lightning talk. My name is Antonov. I'm a senior research scientist at Ascendo Data LLC. Everything presented in this movie can be found in my GitHub account. So what is this about? This presentation is about rapid specification of machine learning workflows using natural language commands. The easiest things to automate with machine learning are machine learning workflows, and in this presentation we demonstrate that with natural language interfaces to machine learning algorithms. As a motivation, consider the following scenario. We want to create a conversational agent or a bunch of conversational agents that help data scientists and machine learning practitioners to quickly create the first initial versions of different data science and machine learning workflows for different programming languages and related packages. We expect those initial versions of programming code to be tweaked further in order to produce desired outcomes in the application area of interest. So the workflows considered quantile regression, latent semantic analysis, and recommendations. These are the workflows considered in this presentation. My first example is going to be based on this data. So this is a data frame, DF temperature data. You see we have two columns, time and temperature. And this is being plotted here. I'm going to show the first quantile regression workflow. This is my first example. It's based on the data frame I showed earlier. So there are three commands, natural language commands here. I'm going to recite them. Create from DF temperature data. Compute quantile regression with 12 nodes and probabilities 0.25, 0.5, and 0.75. Show date list plot with date origin 1900, January 1st. So we can see that the quantile regression did find those curves and at the requested probabilities. So how is this done? For each given machine learning domain, like quantile regression or latent semantic analysis, we create two types of domain-specific languages. The first one is a software monad, or think about a programming language that provides pipelines. And the second one is a domain-specific language where it's a subset of a spoken language, like English, Chinese, Spanish, or something like that. These two domain-specific languages are combined. The natural language commands domain-specific language is translated into the programming pipeline language. By executing those translations, we interpret commands of the spoken domain-specific language into machine learning computational results. Note that we assume that there is a separate system that converts speech, audio into text. This diagram rephrases what I just explained. We have the problem domain. We have developed the software code. This is the yellow rectangles on the left. We have developed the grammars, parsers of the natural language, domain-specific language. This is the rectangles on the green rectangles on the right. At some point, we combine them. We make single-line interpreters. We can make more complicated interpreters. And at some point, we hook up some device like Alexa or Google Home, and we can make a full-blown conversational agent. Grammars and parsers. So for each type of workflow is developed a specialized domain-specific translation module in the language programming language RACU. RACU is also known as Perl 6. Each RACU module has grammars for parsing of sequences of natural commands into of a certain domain-specific language, spoken domain-specific language. And also that model has the ability to translate parsing results into corresponding software monad code. Different programming languages and packages can be a target of that translation. At this point, I have implemented DSL translators to Python, R, and Wolfram language. This quantile regression workflow translation step shown here is based on a sequence of three natural language commands. I'm going to recite them. create from DF temperature data, compute quantile regression with knots 12 and probabilities 0.05, 0.95, find outliers. You see that from this three commands, we produced this three lines of code. The first one, qamon unit, we create the monad object. The second, which is with the quantile regression, we can see that we have the degrees of freedom 12, which corresponds to the knots being specified, and the probabilities, which correspond the probabilities in the command, natural language command. Then we find outliers and we plot, we do a outliers plot. This generated command lines are pasted together and given to the function parse. Parse produces an expression. This expression is being evaluated. And then we get the desired result. The points in blue are the top outliers, the points in red are the bottom outliers. So which was what was requested by that sequence of commands. Okay, my second example, here is a latent semantic analysis workflow. It is based on the Shakespeare's play Hamlet. So in that play, every play part is a document. So I have five commands. I'm going to recite them. Create from text Hamlet. Make document term matrix with automatic stop words and without stemming. Apply LSI functions, global weight function IDF, local term weight function non, normalize function cosine. Extract 12 topics using method SVD, max steps 120 and min number of documents per term 2. Show thesaurus table for ghost and grave. You can see about these five commands, we generate again a monad object. We have made the document term matrix. We apply the term weight functions IDF, non and cosine as specified. Then we extract the topics, 12 topics with the method SVD, maximum steps 120. And then we actually want to echo the statistical thesaurus for the words ghost and grave. In this slide, we paste the programming clients, we give them to parse, and the result of parse is given to eval. So we can see we get this table on the leftmost column is the search term. This is the statistical thesaurus table, which was requested in the last command. So you have the words ghost and grave. And if we know what the play Hamlet is about, we can see that the related statistical thesaurus word like ghost is very close to father and stage and cries, and grave is close to tongue. Honor, sleep, they have apparently a lot to do with Hamlet. All right, so this recommender workflow demonstration, I'm going to use the Titanic data. In this Titanic data, you can see a sample here. I have five columns. The first column is the passenger ID, passenger class is the second column, the third column is passenger age, passenger sex is the fourth column, passenger survival is the fifth column. Is the summary. So I want to make a recommender and make a profile recommendation with that recommender. Here's the sequence of natural language commands. I'm going to recite them. Create from DF Titanic, apply the LSI functions inverse document frequency, term frequency and cosine, compute the top six recommendations for profile female equals one, 30 equals one. Extend recommendations with DF Titanic, show pipeline value. So you can see the result here. I mean, just directly evaluated the result. We can see the result here. We have six recommendations. All of the recommendations adhere to the specified profile. They're about females who have age 30. So two interesting questions. One is handling misspellings. I mean, this is the same series of recommendations workflow commands I had in the previous slide, but I misspelled some of the words. It's like, say, apply recommendations and profile, I misspelled, and you can see the Raku module actually communicated this, handled this. Although these are misspellings, they are recognized that they belong to a certain stencils of commands, so the interpretation proceeded proceed anyway, and so we can see we have, you know, the results which we expect. Another interesting question is, can we this be applied to other computational workflows? Of course it can be. I mean, it follows exactly the same pattern. Since USR 2020 was not held in person because of the COVID-19, so it seems fitting to choose this example here. So this is a specification of epidemiology modeling workflow. You can see, I'm not going to recite the commands, but we're basically using a certain type of well-known model, compartmental epidemiological model. We assign different initial conditions and different rates. This model implies the usage of certain differential equations. So we assign initial conditions and some parameters for this differential equations. We simulate for 240 days and you plot the population results. You can see the generated commands here that correspond to the generated code, which corresponds to the commands given above. And the plot here after evaluation has these typical patterns which we expect from epidemiology compartmental simulations. This last slide has references to all the packages which are used in this presentation. Thank you for your attention.